Hi all, this is Java 1.3 writing classes. To create a class, we need the keyword class followed by the class name. For example, we are creating a class name starter. It can be any name like human, car or anything. Now to make this class accessible for everyone, we will write the keyword public. We will study access specifier in details in my upcoming session. As of now, just understand that we made this class publicly available. And finally, the parenthesis to define our class body. We created a class, but right now it's blank. As we discussed, class defines attributes and behavior. Attributes are class variable and behavior are its method. So now we'll create one method. To create a method, we don't need any keyword. We directly write method name, and in my case, it is main, followed by brackets where we specify arguments. Arguments are like input to method. For example, if the method is addition, which add two numbers, then its argument will be the numbers which you want to add. Right now, I have given argument as string array. What is string array? We'll see in upcoming class. In simple terms, it's a collection of string, like collection of names, Saurabh, Vikas, Abhinav, Tapan, and so on. Next, we need return type. As we give input via arguments, and so method after processing these arguments will give the output. For example, in case of addition method, we gave input as two integers, let's say 3 and 4, and method after adding will return an integer, that is 7, and so its return type will be integer. And in case if method is not returning anything, then the return type will be void. In this demo also, our method is not going to return anything, and so the return type will be void. Now we'll give public access to make it available outside. Next we need static keyword. Again, static is a separate topic which we'll see in later session. Finally, parenthesis to complete method. This method is blank, so now we'll assign it some task. Now this code will result in displaying welcome to ucanon.com on output screen. Println is an inbuilt function. That is, it is already designed and stored in Java, so we can use it. It takes argument as string that you want to display. This string have to be in double quotes. Out represent the out stream as we are accessing the output device. That is our screen to display. And system represent our console. All the statement should end with semicolon. And so we put semicolon at the end. Main is the starting point of our execution. So if you want to create any code, then you need to have a main method and exactly with the same signature, that is public static void main with string array as arguments. You can type this code using any editor like Notepad and save the file with name same as your class.